40 miles south of Candlestick Point as we welcome you inside Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the Levi's Stadium tunnels, and the noise level in this place was deafening. They're set for football as the 49ers get ready to do battle with the Los Angeles Rams. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10. A first carry now for the former Viking. This is Jerick McKinnon, and he's going to be taken down shy of the 10, right around the 9-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Here we go. Black 80!
They run it with McKinnon. Skirts by at the 15. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That one good for 33 and a first.
Sometimes those lines that are drawn on a grease board or in a playbook, they come to life out on the field, don't they? And we just saw down that outside handoff to the right.
That right tackle, he gets excited for that call, doesn't he?
He does, because he just wants to dominate his guy and say, listen, I was the point of attack. I took care of business. That's why you're able to get downfield and add all those yards to your total.
Yeah, really nice game there. Got his target, Pierre Garçon. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Another nice gain, 16 yards there and a first down again.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
So they go from one 42-yard line to the other as they come up now first and 10. Here's McKinnon. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
Now the Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to say?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. Now McKinnon. And a short gain down to about the 33. He needed two, he got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down and a yard.
Well, they picked up a portion of it, but not all that they needed. Now that leads to a decision on fourth and one. Let's see what they decide to do.
Robbie Gould on now to try the field goal. From the right hash and call it an even 50 yards. And Gould is able to put it through. And the 49ers take a 3-0 lead. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yeah.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Mm-hmm. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists. Well,
and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Los Angeles here, they're going to have the ball again on offense. And how about the first 6 weeks of the NFL season for them? Lone undefeated team left. 6-0. First time they've had that since 2001 when they were in St. Louis with the likes of Isaac Bruce, Torrey Holt, and Kurt Warner.
Yeah, and think about what they're doing now. It evokes memories of that team. That team did it in the Midwest. Now they're out on the West Coast doing it. This team is 10-1 on the road under their young coach, Sean McVay. Absolutely fearless about going out and taking on people. They're 7-0 against the AFC. And if they make a Super Bowl run, they'll feel really good about whoever they play on the other side. But how about Jared Goff? People wanted to say that he was a bust as a rookie. Not at all. Just celebrated his 24th birthday, joins Dan Marino and Dante Culpepper as quarterbacks with six straight wins to start a season at age 25 or less.
To throw on second down is gone. And the open receiver, it's Robert Woods. Yeah, he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision, and receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
On first down, it's Gurley. And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. Speaking of Gurley, he was really good again in their win against Denver. Career-high 208 yards versus the Broncos.
And what did we talk about in preseason? I have to bring it back. We talked about potential candidates for MVP. He was one of my strong ones. And when you're leading the NFL in rushing yards, scrimmage yards, and touchdowns, which is 11 through the first 6 weeks, we need to talk about him as the MVP because the epicenter of their offense is Todd Gurley. Whether he's running it, catching it, or creating space for other people to do their thing, Todd Gurley, one of the best players in the NFL.
Here's Goff now on second down. Working the middle here, that's complete to Everett, the tight end. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
A play fake to Gurley, now gone. This is caught, it's Cooks. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. They convert on third with a gain of 22. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
They go play action here on first down. Throw right side is into the hands of his tight end, Everett. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and nine.
Well, they were unable to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost his bread and butter. It's a good running back dive play.
Goff throwing again. Dumps it off to Gurley. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. It'll be a pickup of just two, and just like that, it's third down. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. Throwing on third, gone. Throw complete right side to Cooks. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. This will be the first red zone opportunity now for the Rams. They've got a first and 10 at the 11. To the air again, gone. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing again is gone. And he's got it. That's Cup for a Ram touchdown. as his guys are in for six, and the Rams are in for six. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening, but they found the opening and exploited it.
Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. Zuerlein out now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. And he'll get this one up to the 26. It's a gain of a yard, and it takes us to the two-minute warning. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26.
Hey, Jordan Island over there. Single receiver.
By 20! 180!
Garoppolo to throw on second down. Caught left side, Garcon. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. That's good for a Niner first down. Garoppolo to Garcon. Now a play fake here on first down. And he finds his target. It's Marquise Goodwin. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
Here we go.
Here's Garoppolo on first and 10. He finds his tight end, Salek. And that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. Garoppolo again. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And yet again, it's Garoppolo. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
Well, no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. So now here are the Rams as their offense comes back out. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. On first and 10, Goff. It's caught left side by Cooks. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Give him nine there on the first down completion.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
On second down, here's Goff. Looking this time for Woods, and it's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. And he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line. Woods, the intended receiver.
When we talk about the best corners in the league, we're usually saying shut down corners. Guys, you can't complete passes against. Richard Sherman fits that definition to a T. The best part of his game, no wasted moves. He studies the opponent so well, hard to get a pass on Richard Sherman.
From midfield, here's Garoppolo. To the right side, caught by Salah. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. They'll need the 39 here for a first. This is third down.
Here we go.
On play action, it's Garoppolo. And it's caught by Salah. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 15 yards through the air and a first down.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo. A dump down to McKinnon. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. And Gold is able to put it through, and they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. On the return, it's Pharaoh Cooper. So we've come to halftime. It's the visiting Rams taking the lead to the break. As we'll send you eastward to Orlando, standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach. Cooper on the return. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Rams offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. He works his way forward for a couple up past the 30. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
On the draw, Goff gives to Gurley. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Solomon Thomas there on the tackle.
Go!
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. From the gun, here's Goff. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess.
Here's Johnny Hecker now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because no, tell me.
That's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker boards?
Yeah, those two.
So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
The rush defense stout on first down. Here's second and 10 from the 20. They run once more with McCannon. And he's got Rome. Shifts by him. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
So after the run by McKinnon, here's first and 10.
Hey, here we go, here we go.
Now Garoppolo on the bootleg. And Salek here, left side. No gain there on the completion, second and 10. Well, he caught it right at the line of scrimmage, and before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch, and most offenses make a living off of yards after catch. Those hidden yards that may not go into the score sheet, but they count big for moving the ball and stretching the field. Really nice open field tackle.
McKinnon. And down he goes just beyond the 35, and that pretty move got him some extra space to run. He's able to rattle off six on the carry, and that'll get him to third and four.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
The Niners on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and four.
Here we go.
A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. Goodwin able to haul it in. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Garoppolo to Goodwin there for a 49er first.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
They fake the give. Now Garoppolo looks to throw. And the Rams got it. They bring him down. Aaron Donald. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and they're going to be staring at a third and long here.
The best offenses and the ones that win are ones that make adjustments. And right now, I think this team needs to open things up.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long.
180! 120!
Back now here in Santa Clara. And we've got a dandy here. A one-point game as we begin the fourth. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long.
Working from the gun, Garoppolo. Looking deep downfield. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10.
Black 80! Black 80!
Garoppolo now, first down throw. And bringing it in, this is Salek over the middle. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
As a passer, you're always trying to find that open window to throw the ball downfield. How about this one? Right in the middle of the field, right in the heart of the defense.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. And this is Salek here with a grab. And he'll go down at the 28. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
So they need 2 yards here on 3rd down. Remember, they're already 2 of 2 on 3rd down conversions on this drive. Again, they'll throw with Garoppolo. And able to find Dawson. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. Garoppolo now, 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's 1st and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And good downhill running. He's got 6 yards down to the 13.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on 1st down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Play action, Garoppolo. And that is, I think he caught it. He did, but they'll say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete. Trent Taylor, the one he was looking for. And that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down.
Okay, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe he didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, 4th quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? Are the legs still there? This has been a tough game.
Here we go.
180! And they'll run it here. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down.
Yeah, baby. Yeah,
have to
baby.
Kick this field goal, don't you?
No question about it. Look at the clock. Look at the situation. Kick the field goal.
So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. So the field goal unit is on the field as this is a big spot right here. And Gold is able to put it through. And they have taken the lead here in the final 2 minutes. Big kick right there to give them the lead in the 4th, but there is still time left for a final drive.
Did they score too soon? Post-game will tell us, right? Depending on what happens on this drive, that's how we'll analyze it. If the other team scores, they scored too soon. If they somehow hold on, they've managed the clock exactly right.
The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close,
You've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll try and start the drive with Gurley. A very good move, but for a relatively modest gain out near the 32. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. He's back to throw. He gets it to Cooks. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. First down now, but that clock rolling. Back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Following the penalty, it's 1st and 5, and you got to think offensively, all kinds of options. Back to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for 2nd down. He'll look to throw. And he comes back with 1 complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 1st down, L.A. Goff finding Higbee. They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they? Just down a score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.
They go play action here on 1st down. And it's incomplete. Garrett Celek, the tight end, was the target. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
All right, that one fell incomplete there, but the best quarterbacks, they'll miss on 40% of their throws somewhere in that neighborhood, similar to a great hitter in baseball who's going to fail 7 out of 10 times and still have a great year. In this case, you want perfection, but way better that it hits the ground instead of going to an opposite color jersey.
And they'll go on the ground. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. The Niners on 3rd down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is 3rd down and 12.
We got 3. We got 3. Here we go.
Garoppolo to throw. He's got his man on the crossing route. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Yeah, the Rams are going to go ahead and take another timeout, as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. Down to a knee for the 49ers. This one about to be on ice. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here, as the clock will stop with 35 seconds left to go.
Three.
Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it.
I don't know about you, partner, but watching them take the knee there and finish this one off, I feel like I'm going to be sore tomorrow. This was one bruising affair, low scoring, but my kind of football.
Not a work of art, but maybe in your world, a little bit of a work of art. I like the defensive side.
I thought it was pretty. I can't help myself. I thought it was pretty.
And it ends in a kneel down as the clock rolls down to zeros. Well, Charles, the old saying, the old cliche, if you will, points at a premium. That certainly applied here, didn't it?
And that almost felt like opened up a time capsule, didn't it? Old school football, low scoring, close game. What a way to finish it up.
You loved it, didn't you? You loved the defenses.
I certainly did. Brought back the images of the game of old.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The 49ers get the win here at home as we say so long from Santa Clara.